So, well, hi there. This is another video from me. It's about walkie-talkies. And this is another walkie-talkie that I have. And I've already made a video about it. And in today's video, I want to tell you some stuff about these walkie-talkies. About these walkie-talkies. There are many circuits on the web that are quite simple, and they are inviting you to rebuild them if you are interested in building your own walkie-talkie. And I will tell you that there are some traps in these simple circuits, and I'll show you which one they are. The first one is the push-to-talk switch, because on these walkie-talkies you have a push-to-talk switch. It has 8 contacts, 4 for transmit and 4 for receive. Also, you will find some of these, not these specific, but some of these that look like these inductors in a walkie-talkie. They are looking similar than this one, with a slug that is tunable. And you will find 1 or 2 of these in a walkie-talkie. And if you are going to get the parts for the walkie-talkie, you will get the capacitors, you will get the resistors, electrolytic capacitors, even the transistors, no problem, and even the potentiometer for the volume with the switch, that all can be bought. But you will probably have trouble finding these transformers and finding this push-to-talk 8 contact switch. You can buy transformers that are like this, and then you can rewind them, but therefore you would need to know how is the value of the slug or the core of the transformer, and also how many turns do you require to wind it. So that's the problem. And here I'll tell you, or I'll show you, how these simple walkie-talkie circuits work. This is just a basic schematic. So here all you have the red connectors, which are set for transmit. And then we have the green connectors, which are set for receive. Either all red connectors are connected at the same time, and then the green ones aren't connected, or all green connectors are connected at the same time, and then the red ones aren't connected. Now let's see the situation if the transmitter, at the transceiver, is set in receive. So we have a so-called superregenerative receiver around here with the transistor. The capacitor goes from base to ground. There's a coil in emitter which prevents the transmitter from oscillating, so we get this so-called superregenerative receiver type. There is a pickup that picks up the RF signal and feeds it into the amplifier. And of course, the amplifier is connected to the loudspeaker. On the superregenerative receiver, you get 2 signals. You get the audio signal, and you also get the the quench frequency. You get the quench frequency. For example, you get audio signal and 25 to 40 kilohertz or kilocycles. And therefore, at least the first transistor has a capacitor from base to emitter to prevent the signal, the 40 kilohertz or 25 kilohertz, something in that range, from being amplified. So, I've seen circuits where there's no coil. Instead of that, they are using another resistor. So it's obviously possible to use a resistor instead of the coil and get it also in superregenerative mode. It does work, but it's very hard to do. So use a coil which changes nothing to the overall function of the circuit. This is the pretty clever thing with this transformer that you will need, because it's doing much stuff. First, we have a tank circuit with a fixed capacitor and a tunable coil that is tuned to the 27 MHz, or it could be also 40.68 or 49 MHz. Then we have, this is like 9 turns, 10 turns, and then we have 2 turns or 3 turns for the pickup coil or RF induction coil, if you want to call it like that, because this is a transformer with high impedance here, low impedance there. And now we have the antenna, which is of course way too short for 11 meters. It's a few centimeters long, and so it has a high impedance, like a few kilo ohms. And this has a low impedance, like a few hundred ohms, or even just a few ohms. If you now connect this antenna directly here, it won't work. It will work, it will transmit and receive, but very poor quality. So you add another serious LC circuit that matches the antenna from high impedance to low impedance. Why don't you just connect the high impedance antenna directly here? Well, on one side, you don't want to affect the receiver's frequency too much if you touch the antenna, or if there's the load being changed from the antenna by environmental issues or whatever. So you take 2 filters, or 2 coils. And also, if you transmit, you have 1 harmonic filter there with this first tank circuit, and a second harmonic filter there with this very narrow-banded LC circuit. So that's why you use two circuits. And also you will find a variable coils for the second coil. Sometimes you will find two coils that can be tuned in such a circuit. And sometimes you will find instead of the second variable coil just an inductor, like I am using inductors. Why am I using inductors and haven't rewound one of these coils? Well, pretty simple answer. I wanted to get done with the circuit as soon as possible to make a video and get it done. So this circuit also, it is working, but it's just a demonstration circuit, not a circuit that you could really use. I mean, especially the range is very bad and lots of stuff isn't really too well working in there. And I didn't really care about optimizing it. I just wanted it to work too, so I can make the video. And it does work good enough to make a video about it. And that's all I wanted from the circuit. So now this circuit already is set up and it's set in a receive mode. And I will go and show you the receive mode. I turn it on and you have this typical static sound that you may know from these cheap walkie-talkies. And now I turn on, I have a testing transmitter set up, which one I'll turn on. And do we be able to hear the testing message being transmitted by this test transmitter over there and received by the homemade walkie-talkie? Okay, as you could hear, this was the test transmission. And now, as I said, all the green connectors are connected. And now I'm going to put this one as transmitter. I'm not changing any components, I'm just changing the connections. And it is like as if you push the push-to-talk button, which pretty much rewires a huge amount of the circuitry. So, for doing that, I'll have to place the camera there, because I have to do that with both hands. Doing that one hand is not really good. First thing I'm going to change is the loudspeaker. I'm going to connect the loudspeaker to the input from the amplifier, so the loudspeaker now acts as a microphone. Then I'm disconnecting the coil from the emitter of the transistor and connect instead of that the resistor. And then at last, I'm connecting the crystal to the base. So here I have a receiver, which is set on 27 megahertz. And I show you now, currently nothing is being received because the transmitter isn't turned to the battery. And as you can see, it's receiving 27 megahertz. And now I turn on the transmitter and you can hear this sound. That's not a problem. That's because the microphone is so sensitive, it does get an audio feedback. So I turn down the volume and as you can see, it works now. So now I'll hold the receiver to the camera's microphone. So now I talk into the loudspeaker from the walkie-talkie circuit. I hope you can hear it. I'm talking in the loudspeaker from the walkie-talkie circuit. Okay, so you could probably hear it does work, although the quality is pretty bad. But that's just performance. I mean, I could probably get a good performance. I could optimize the circuit that it does work quite well. But I think there's no point in doing that. I just want to get something that runs and works for demonstration purposes. Because there are many schematics of these type of walkie-talkies on the web. And you can find some of them and you can attempt to reboot them. Another thing about these walkie-talkies is that I'm using a resistor here in the last transistor stage from collector to plus. But I've seen many walkie-talkies that use a small transformer. It's round about as big as the black base of this coil, so the black base and the upper side of the coil. So round about that big. And this is an audio transformer that transforms the higher voltage, which is like a few volts from the collector to plus, to a lower voltage with therefore more current, because if the speaker gets more current, it's going to be louder. Okay, that's pretty much how these simple walkie-talkie circuits work. Rebuilding them, I've told you the pros and cons about it. And yeah, that's pretty much. So one more information. As transmitter, the crystal is connected. It's defining the frequency where on the transmitter is transmitting. We have a selective circuit here that filters out 27 megahertz. And we have another selective circuit here that also filters out 27 megahertz and amplifies them. The amplifier then becomes the modulator. The loudspeaker is connected to the amplifier's input in transmit mode. It has a microphone preamp, which is two or three transistors, and the last transistor is the modulator for the transmitter stage. This capacitor is taken out, and this capacitor is in, because this capacitor it did change the frequency. I mean, when I was having this in, it was transmitting on 20 kilohertz difference from the receiving frequency. So like receive 27 megahertz, transmit 26.980. So I took that out, now it works. And as you can see here, there's this resistor. This acts a little bit like an RF choke. And also it does limit the current from the audio amplifier to the transistor. And this capacitor is in, it filters out the RF that is still going back from the resistor to the amplifier, it shorts it out to ground. So this is pretty much the very simple walkie-talkie design. I hope this was an informative video, I hope it was helping you a little bit if you plan to build one of these simple walkie-talkie circuits. Yeah, and that's pretty much the video about simple walkie-talkies. Best regards, Stefan.